Well, there is a heavy police presence here tonight as protesters settle in for what looks to be a long night. Tents have been erected, fires have been lit, and there's been a steady stream of people going on and off the private land. Now, they were joined by hundreds of people today, finally giving this issue some real momentum. Angry and raw on the front line. Hundreds protesting at Ihuamātao today.
Very proud to be from Aotearoa on a day like this, when you see people from all walks of life come to Ihuamātao to defend it.
Pania Newton has been leading a peaceful protest here since 2016, but it's only just now gaining widespread traction.
I just think it's very, very wrong, and so I couldn't not be here to support.
For me, it's really teaching my kids as well in part of the history.
At issue are Fletcher's housing development to be built next door to this historic reserve, considered a wāhi tapu and archaeologically significant. Parts of the day light-hearted, organisers encouraging a family atmosphere, but there were tense moments. In the last 10 minutes, occupiers moving from the roadside onto private farmland, police streaming after them in what feels like an escalation. This man challenging police before being arrested, not the only incident. Two dogs pepper sprayed and another woman arrested after wedging herself on a truck, prompting a plea for calm.
We urge protesters to continue to act peacefully and not behave in a manner that puts their own safety or the safety of others at risk.
The political iwi dynamics here are complex. Te Kawarawa Maki supports the development. It's worked with Fletchers, and iwi members will receive 40 homes.
This will be the first time that anyone has given us back land that had been confiscated. That's a huge thing.
Fletcher's saying safety is a priority and it will continue to work with mana whenua.
People have described this as our last bastion. What we know is that the government can still intervene.
We come in over the top, it really would be undermining the local iwi in this case.
Outside the debating chamber though, a solidarity march and a makeshift roadblock bringing traffic to a standstill.
The original injustice has always been the crown theft of tangata whenua land.
With no end in sight, the scale of a land protest like this, not seen in decades.
All right, let's go back live to Yvonne. Yvonne, this has been going on for some time. What sparked this surge of interest in Ihuamātao?
Well, timing is everything, and what's important here is that this protest is happening at the same time as Indigenous issues come under the spotlight globally. Native Hawaiians have been protesting at Mauna Kea. Now, that's their sacred mountain. The summit is considered sacred, and that's their tallest as well. That project's worth $1.4 billion. So that's an issue that's really grabbed the headlines. Now, as for what happens here, well, this has been going on for 2.5 years, and an easy solution doesn't seem anywhere in sight.
Kia ora, Yvonne, live from Auckland's Māngere, Yvonne Tahana.